I had an opportunity to visit Marshall Buck at his shop in Long Island, New York. Marshall is a model maker that specializes in making some of the country's best scale model cars. These are hand-built custom cars that are as intricate as perhaps the cars they represent. Before we went into his shop, I asked Marshall how long he's been making these models.
Too long.
Yeah.
I mean, since I was a kid, I was doing models. Uh-huh. And then in terms of professionally, I started really getting into, you know, 1982. I was building models on the side.
Uh-huh.
And then just kind of snowballed, you know.
The workshop is where Marshall spends most of his time making these works of art. And I was excited to learn more.
My very first production models were the Aston Martins down here, these three, mm-hmm. the DB3S road mm-hmm. cars. And those actually, you know, we had the pattern and then I contracted it out. And we produced those and retailed and sold them worldwide.
Mm-hmm. And how old are those about?
What, like when those you first started are 1989. Those? So my first production piece was 89. Most of what's on the shelves in terms of the cases are models that were CMA production pieces, mm-hmm. as well as a few custom build items.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for my first large scale model, which was a CMA model, which was the Barquettas, mm-hmm. we did a few different versions. We did three distinctively different chassis numbers.
What was the motivation for you to do
it? It was pure accident. I mean, I was in accident. At that point, I had moved into the post production side of the TV. I was uh-huh. working at Lorne Michaels' facility at uh-huh. Broadway Video.
Uh-huh.
I was miserable there. And I was built, but it was, you know, it was a staff position. I was building models on the side. And one of my customers, a big car guy, said, you know, I was delivering models to him one day in Manhattan. And he said, what do you do for me when you're not building models for a living? I told him, so we talked. He said, well, you know, you're pretty good. You know, you could, you know, really could do this. Conversation progressed, went back and forth. And, at the outset, you know, he offered to bankroll me and to put me, you know, to back me and to put me into business.
Oh, great.
And, kind of the rest is history. It's, mm-hmm. it's a tough way to make a living.
Right.
You know, it's hard to do. And also for, you know, people to appreciate. There are a lot of people that do get it. They understand what goes into it because it's a craft or an art like anything else.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, interpreting the shapes and really trying to get the shapes right and the details and finesse it all so that it looks right, so you have an accurate model. I mean, a lot of people can build a model, but many people can't really create or do a great mm-hmm. model build job.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go. Yeah. Okay.
Right,
so this is a Tabulago.
There are two of them. This is the way the car was originally. This is being done from scratch, and the one I'm going to show you, which is a little further along because it's the client's car.
Mm-hmm.
This I'm doing for myself as a showpiece because I need something to show.
Right.
So I'm doing the way the car was originally. And
okay.
besides the color differences, there are a few other detail differences on it. But this is the the one for the client in progress now. So.
Yeah.
Scratch Built begins with research and hundreds of pictures.
In terms of this, is I generally go out and I see the client's car. So I went out to mm-hmm. the client's house,
mm-hmm.
and I spent several days out in Maryland,
mm-hmm.
Where the car was, and extensive amount of photos, different, you know, areas, sure. profiles, you know, all the, you know, various details. People don't realize it's not just going out and taking a few measurements,
mm-hmm.
you know, something. It's all the areas and how they relate to, you know, and then, you know, multiple areas on this.
Scaling everything
exactly.
down.
Exactly. And then I've got to reduce it to scale. This is for the steering spokes.
Mm-hmm.
This was created from a flat piece of styrene.
Mm.
You know, I did a whole, it took multiple step processes, you know, doing the drawing, cutting it out, each one of the finger grips that was put on, raised, then shaved down, sanded, then the filler glues that were put in to make it flow right and just those. And then we've got the center hub. You know, again, a graphic artist, you know, produced these. And this is just, we're just doing for the model.
Yeah.
You know, labels for dash switches, you know, things I've got, you know, here we've got, you know, bumpers, a couple of grills done up.
It's beautiful.
You know, some of the detail switch pieces.
Marshall also had boxes of parts from past projects done in different scales. The wire wheels were amazing in detail with individually laced wheels. Everything from Baranis to Hallibrands were in stock. We also discussed how model making has changed from resin molds to the use of computer-aided design. Rapid prototyping is the new technology, but it has its challenges.
You can only get it so far on the computer. You cannot get it perfect.
no matter what.
So what process is this? This is what.
This is rapid prototyping.
This is rapid prototyping. So now this is the stuff that is in the pool of polymer,
liquid,
and then they
exactly.
and then they draw
they cure
it
with a UV or laser,
right? And then it pops out of the pool.
Exactly. So again, you can look at some of where I had to move where the gas filler was.
Mm-hmm.
Tweaking just areas. Did the cutout underneath and just simple little bits. Again, I should really finalize the shaping.
Still, it's not quick. Right. It's not quick because of all the back and forth with this. If I was
making
a widget
for CAD,
if I was doing a nut and bolt, it would be great. But because of this, if you look at the shape, this is one of the toughest shapes to get.
Mm-hmm.
This, there's no straight line on it, and you need somebody that can really interpret when you send them all the photos, or I can say, no, you know what? Take a look at that front view again. The corner's all wrong. Or
right.
Here's where you've got to, and you've got to have the eye for it too, because the computer's only going to do what
sure.
you tell it to do. Some of the advantages are, if I want to do this later in a different scale, what we did is we had a test shot done in a different material, a different prototyping place.
Okay.
See, this is a different machine, different material. We had it done in 1/24th scale first.
Once all the work is done finalizing the shape, Marshall can produce a run of bodies. But the work is far from over. I had Marshall show some of the details in putting together a high-end scratch-built car.
Here we've got, those are the washers.
Mm-hmm.
I've got one on there. One of the, there's a lower row which has the stud pin standing through just a little bit, which I sanded down from the castings, and the others don't have them at all. They go on the top row. So again, there are a couple of differences. Inside goes a simulated little brass mount for the crank that would have been in there. So that'll be in there. And then, they'll be painted flat black. So it'll be the bolt heads on the washers, and those will go on. And
I always admired the level of detail found on high-end scale model cars, but Marshall showed me how much further he has taken his profession. I want to thank Marshall Buck for the tour of the CMA Models shop and the education in scratch-built model making. If you want to learn more about Marshall Buck's shop, go to cmamodels.com. This has been a production of TomYoung.net. Thanks for watching.